0. Back-to-back tough weeks for the Falcons. It's basically been downhill since the second half of that Super Bowl. Not gonna lie. So, that's tough. Next up, we got the Cowboys at the Chiefs. Of course, I picked my Cowboys to win. That was just a tough game, dude. Tough game. I mean, honestly, our defense, I think our defense played really well, considering just how bad our offense was, just giving the ball back right away to the Chiefs. Our defense held up very well, only allowing 19 points on the road against the Chiefs, so I'll take that. But yeah, our offense absolutely struggled. No Amari Cooper for this game, and you could definitely tell. And to make matters worse, CeeDee Lamb ended up with a concussion at the end of the second half, I believe it was. But, or maybe it was the third quarter, I don't remember, but one of those. So he might be out for Thursday's Thanksgiving game, hopefully not, but we will see. But yeah, tough loss, really wanted to get that win, but our offense really just looked awful all around. Next up, we got the Colts at the Bills, and Jonathan Taylor, man, absolutely had himself a game. This dude is a monster. He had 5 touchdowns, one receiving touchdown, 4 rushing. Dude, he's just been going off. I wish I had him. This guy's gonna be a very, very high pick in next year's fantasy draft, for sure. And the Colts are looking good. This was a big win on the road for them. I picked the Bills to win this one, but Colts just steamrolled them. Next up, we got the Ravens at the Bears. The Ravens pick up the 3-point win without Lamar Jackson. Lions at Browns. Browns squeak out a 3-point win. Baker Mayfield was playing. And they got a very close win against the Lions, who are now 0-9-1. Hate to see it. Next up, we got the Texans at the Titans. The Texans pulled off the win. I actually picked the Titans to win this one, so we were off on that. But yeah, somehow the Texans pulled off a dub to get their second of the season. Packers at Vikings. I did pick the Packers for this one, and it was close. It was close. The Vikings ended up winning on a last-second field goal. Aaron Rodgers threw 4 touchdowns. He went off, but just wasn't enough. Justin Jefferson balled out right there. Dolphins at Jets. Dolphins pick up the dub against Joe Flacco. Wow. It's been a while. I honestly didn't know he was still in the NFL, but back on the Jets, I guess. Poor guy. Next up, we got the Saints at the Eagles. We picked the Eagles to win this one, and they did. The Saints are just really struggling ever since that Jameis Winston injury. I kind of made it a close game here, but it really wasn't that close. I mean, the Eagles a huge lead in the first half and then just kind of coasted to the win. Next up, we got the football team at the Panthers. Cam Newton making a start today and unfortunately couldn't pull off the dub. It was a close one, but the football team gets the W there. 49ers at Jaguars. 49ers get the dub. Bengals at Raiders, got the Bengals there. Cardinals beat the Seahawks. I did pick the Seahawks to win that one. So I missed that one. And then last but not least, Steelers and Chargers, which ended up being a very good game. Came down to the very end, but Chargers get the big home win there. So yeah, I think we missed. Six games wrong that week. That's tough. Wait, so that means we got... Okay, so we went 9-6. That's not bad. Alright, so let's make some picks for week 12. We got the Raiders and the Cowboys. Of course, I'm gonna go with my Cowboys here. Texans, is this gonna be Joe Flacco starting? Jets, dude. Let's go Jets. J-E-T-S, bro. Joe Flacco on the road gets the dub. Chargers at Broncos. I'll take the Chargers here to get the road win. Rams at Packers. Wow. Yeah. I mean, it won't quite be a December game, but close enough. Close enough to December game at Lambeau against Aaron Rodgers. I'll take the Packers. Yeah. Maybe Stafford is looking a little bit better, but he was looking pretty rough before their bye week. I'll take the Packers here. Vikings at 49ers. I'll take the 49ers. They look great last game. Vikings are looking pretty good though. But I'll take the 49ers here. They have too many weapons. Browns at Ravens. Is Lamar gonna be playing? I don't know. I'll take the Ravens at home though against the Browns. The Browns offense has looked really bad. And then Seahawks at the football team. Seahawks, they basically gotta win this game. Their season is, they're like on the brink of a completely lost season, which is very surprising with the offense they have. I guess Chris Carson is out for the year. But I mean, they still have DK. They have Russ. You would think they'd be able to make something happen, but not yet. Not yet. I'll take the Seahawks here, though. So, yeah, those are my picks for week 12. We'll take a look at them we'll take a look at them next week and see how we do. But let's take a look at our team. Yeah. Unfortunately, we took a big loss. And this was not good. This one actually really hurt. Now, we are projected to win by almost 10 points going into the week, but our team just did not play well. I mean, Tom did pretty good. He had 19.2. James Robinson finished with 10.8. It's just tough because he plays for the Jaguars and they always get behind. So they have to get rid of the running game pretty quickly. Leonard Fournette ended up with 10.4. Corey Davis had a solid 5 points against the Dolphins. Michael Pittman with 3.3. I mean, Jonathan Taylor had a million touchdowns, so there's not much you can do about that. Kyle Pitts had 4.4. They got destroyed. Mark Ingram, though, ended up with a pretty solid game, 12.3, filling in for Alvin Kamara. Bills defense got me -4, got destroyed by the Colts. And then Justin Tucker with 11 points. Yeah, so it was pretty much all bad. Really no highlights, nothing really good to take out of this one, unfortunately. So we're gonna drop to 5-6 after this. Let me take a look at the standings here. And so I actually looked at the scoreboard before this, so we'll drop to 5-6. This team right here will go up to 6-5, as well as this team right here will go to 6-5. Team Gripman, will drop to 5-6 as well. So, we're gonna be sitting at 6th place after this week. Top 6 teams make the playoffs. must win for us. So let's get a look at what our team is looking like for next week. Looks like Saquon is going to be back, allegedly. So we'll go ahead and put him in. Although he's been getting pretty solid volume. Just not really getting the touchdowns that he would need to make him worth starting. Knee sprain, so he's probably out for a little bit. Which doesn't really matter because Miles Sanders is back. So yeah, kind of in a tough spot anyway. Yeah, with this lineup right here, we are projected 115.4. I might keep the Bills defense in right there. That's really not too bad. But let's go ahead and take a look at some of the top performers over the week and see if there's anyone worth adding. Just go to all performers and see. So Cam Newton with the top spot, 26.16. Elijah Moore, I consider picking this guy up after last week's performance. This guy might be a good grab. 11 targets, 8 catches. Oh, and they're going to be playing against the Texans. If you guys can grab this guy, I would definitely do it. Elijah Moore. Valdez Scantling went off with 20 points. Okay, best game of the season for sure. I don't know if I would grab him. That looks a little too inconsistent. So Devontae Freeman, not even really like a good game, honestly, like 3.1 yards a carry, but he did get 6 catches for 31 yards. I just, like, the volume is pretty decent, but with like that small of a yards per attempt average, I just don't know if he will like hang on to that volume going forward. That's a tough one. I don't know. Let's see how Rojo did. 8 carries, 33 yards. Elijah Moore. He's been going off lately. Season. I really hope we win. I actually asleep. Hopefully you guys are already asleep or very relaxed. Hope you guys enjoy.